click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we'll discuss one question based on Halsey plan and Rowan plan, where we are going to calculate time wages as well as piece rate of wages. Wage negotiations are going on with recognized labor union, and management wants you as cost accountant of company to formulate an incentive scheme with view to increase productivity. Here they have given a concept like case study where company is negotiating with the trade union to fix the wage rate. Management wants advice how to increase productivity by introducing incentive scheme. The case of three typical workers, Achyut, Anant and Govinda, who produce respectively 180, 120 and 100 units of company's product in normal day of 8 hours is taken up for study. For study purpose, as a model, company is using the work performed by three workers, Achyut, Anant and Govind. They are differing in output. Achyut 180 units, Anant 120 units and Govind 100 units in a normal day of 8 hours. Based on this model study, actual incentive scheme to be formed. Assuming that day wages would be guaranteed at 75 paise per hour. Here there is guarantee of 75 paise per hour. That means worker fails to achieve the standard target, still there is assurance that he will be getting minimum amount of wages. That is, guarantee is given 75 paise per hour, and the piece rate would be based on standard hourly output of 10 units. Calculate the earnings of each of three workers and the labor cost per 100 pieces under day wages, piece rate, Halsey scheme, Rowan scheme. Also calculate under the above schemes the average cost of labor for the company to produce 100 pieces. Let us do working. Daily wages guaranteed 75 paise per hour and normal day is of 8 hours. So we can calculate normal wages. It is rupees 6 per day. So in case of employee Achyut, day wages is guaranteed normal wages 6 rupees. In case of Anant, 6 rupees. Govinda, 6 rupees. We got their actual output 180, 120 and 100 units. Now we can calculate cost for 100 pieces. daily wages 6 rupees, divided by actual output 180 units, multiplied by 100 units to get cost per 100 pieces, it comes to 3 rupees 33 paise. In case of Anant, six by 120 multiplied by 100, it is 5 rupees. In case of Govind, it is 6 rupees. We can calculate total daily wages paid, 6 plus 6 plus 6, it is 18 rupees. Actual output 180 plus 120 plus 100, 400 units. Average cost of labor for company to produce 100 pieces, that we have calculated. Now we are required to find out average cost of labor for company. Total wages paid 18 rupees, total number of units 400 units, for 100 pieces multiplied by 100. So it is 4 rupees 50 paise. So as per day wages method, we are getting average labor cost 4 rupees 50 paise. Now we'll compute wages as per piece rate. Three workers, Achyut, Anant, Govind, and their output 180, 120 and 100 units. In question we have given here the information of piece rate. Piece rate would be based on standard hourly output of 10 units. Daily wages would be guaranteed 75 paise per hour. This is standard rate. Based on this, we are required to calculate piece rate. In this case, piece rate will be 0.075 paise per unit. We can calculate wages earned by multiplying actual output with piece rate. So in case of Achyut, it comes 13 rupees 50 paise. Anant 9 rupees, Govind 7 rupees 50 paise, actual output 400 units, total wages 30 rupees. Now we are required to calculate labor cost per 100 pieces. So for one piece it is 0.075, so for 100 pieces it will be 0.075 multiplied by 100. So in each case it will be 7 rupees 50 paise. average cost of labor for company to produce 100 pieces, 30 rupees divided by 400 units multiplied by 100 units, it comes to 7 rupees 50 paise. Let us calculate wages as per HALSE premium plan. As per HALSE plan, when a worker shows more efficiency, we give motivation to him by providing some incentives. For that purpose, we are required to fix a standard time for completing a job, which is called as time allowed. This will be compared with actual time taken by the worker. If a worker completes the job before standard time, the amount of time saved will be considered for incentive. In this case, the wages for time saved will be equal to 50% of normal wages. For example, if he saves 10 minutes, he will be paid for 5 minutes at normal wage rate. This is how we calculate bonus in case of HALSE plan. Let us do the working. Three workers, Achyut, Anant, Govind, their respective output 180 units, 120 units and 100 units. We'll have to calculate now standard time for actual output. Here they have given information based on standard hourly output of 10 units. That means in a particular hour we need to complete 10 units and hourly guaranteed rate is given 75 paise, that is standard rate. Actual output is 180 units per hour. Standard output is 10 units, so 180 divided by 10. Here we are getting the time required, standard time required for actual output, which comes to 18 hours. In case of Ananta, it will be 12 hours. In case of Govind, it will be 10 hours. So we have calculated standard time for actual output. Now we'll consider actual time for actual output. Now all these outputs are taken in a particular day, normal day of 8 hours. So each worker has taken 8 hours. So actual time for actual output, 8 hours. We can find out time saved by comparing the difference standard time for actual output and time taken for actual output. In case of Achyut, 18 minus 8, 10 hours saved. In case of Anant, 12 minus 8, 4 hours saved. In case of Govind, 10 minus 8, 2 hours saved. Bonus we have to calculate as 50% of time saved. So we'll be taking 50% of this time saved hours. So 10, 50% will be 5 hours. 4, 50% will be 2 hours. to 50% will be 1 hour. Total wages including bonus, that is for 5 hours plus 8 hours. In case of Achyut, 8 hours plus 5 hours, it will be 13 hours at the rate of 0.75 per hour. So it will be 9 rupees 75 paise. In case of Anant, 8 hours plus 2 hours, that is 10 hours multiplied by 0.75, 7 rupees 50 paise. In case of Govind, 8 plus 1, 9 hours ₹6.75. We can add all these wages, it comes to ₹24. Now we are required to calculate labor cost per 100 pieces. In case of Achyut, wages are 9.75 for 180 units. So 9.75 divided by 180 multiplied by 100. It is approximately 5 rupees 42 paise. In case of Anant, 7 rupees 50 paise wages divided by output 120 units multiplied by 100, 6 rupees 25 paise. In case of Govind, 6 rupees 75 paise divided by output 100 units multiplied by 100, so it will be 6 rupees 75 paise. So we have calculated under Halsey plan labor cost per 100 pieces, as well as we have calculated respective wages. Let us start computation as per Rowan scheme. Three workers, Achyut, Anant, Govind, respective output 180 units, 120 units, 100 units. Achyut output is 180 units. Anand 120 units, Govind 100 units. Let us calculate standard time for actual output. This we got in our last working. Standard time for actual output 18 hours, 12 hours, 10 hours. Actual time taken in hours every day 8 hours. Time saved. We have to compare standard time for actual output and actual time taken, 18 minus 8. So time saved in this case 10 hours, 12 minus 8, time saved 4 hours, 10 minus 8, time saved 2 hours. We have to calculate now bonus hours. Formula for bonus hour is time taken multiplied by time saved divided by standard time. In case of Achyut, time taken is, actual time taken here is 8 hours. Time saved 10 hours. And standard time they have given here, standard time for actual output 18 hours. So in this case, bonus hours is 4.44. In case of Anant, time taken 8 hours, time saved 4 hours, standard time for actual output 12 hours. 2.67. So bonus hours here is 2.67. In case of Govind, bonus hours is equal to time taken multiplied by time saved divided by standard time. Here time taken 8 hours multiplied by time saved 2 hours, standard time for actual output 10 hours. So in case of Govind, bonus hours ₹1.6. We can calculate now bonus at the rate of 75 paise per hour. It is 1 rupee 20 paise. Now we can calculate total earnings of worker. In case of Achyut, 6 rupees plus 3.33 paise, so it comes to 9 rupees 33 paise. In case of Anant, 6 plus 2, 8 rupees. In case of Govind, 6 plus 1 rupee 20 paise, 7 rupee 20 paise. We can add column total wages. ₹24.53. We can now calculate labor cost per 100 pieces. In case of Achyut, total earnings are ₹9.33. We are required to calculate for 100 pieces. So ₹9.33 divided by 180 units multiplied by 100 units. So it will be ₹5.18. In case of Anant, 8 rupees divided by 120 units multiplied by 100, ₹6.67. In case of Govind, ₹7.20 divided by 100 units multiplied by 100 units. So it will be ₹7.20. So we have also calculated labor cost per 100 pieces in case of each worker. We are required to calculate average cost of labor for company. Total wages paid ₹24.53 divided by total output 180 plus 120 plus 100, it comes to 400 units. Per unit it comes to 0.0613. For 100 units we are required to multiply this with 100, so it comes ₹6.13. In this question we have calculated average labor cost, wages under 4 different methods. Thanks for watching this video. Stay in tune with Ikeda and subscribe to our channel Ikeda. Thank you.